बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, सब्जेक्ट जूलॉजी, सेकेंड ईयर प्री मेडिकल, टॉपिक नेम इज रेगुलेशन ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट बॉडी टेम्परेचर इन मेन। द ह्यूमन बॉडी टेम्परेचर इज 36.8 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड और 98.6 डिग्री फारेनहाइट। सो देयर आर द वेज इन द बॉडी टू कंट्रोल ओवर हीटिंग और ओवर कूलिंग। फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस अबाउट ओवर हीटिंग, एनर्जेटिक एक्टिविटी, डिजीज, एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ रेडिएशन फ्रॉम द सन and many other external causes may bring about the overheating. It produces two marked effects in skin. Number one is vasodilation and number two is sweating. Vasodilation, it is the expansion of blood vessels, that is an increase in their diameter so that more blood flows through them. In vasodilation, whenever the body gets too hot, vasodilation occurs in the dense network of capillaries which lie just beneath the epidermis of the skin. These capillaries open up and let a large volume of overheated blood flow very close to the body surface. Here the blood rapidly loses heat by radiation through the skin. In this figure, two processes, overheating and overcooling. In the process of overheating, vasodilation, and the process of overcooling is vasoconstriction. In the process of vasodilation, it is the expansion of blood vessels, that is an increase in diameter so that more blood flows through them. Whenever the body gets too hot, vasodilation occurs in the dense network of capillaries. Here in the process of vasodilation, heat loss occurs the epidermis. Epidermis is the skin layer. In the process of vasodilation, expansion of the blood vessels or heat loss occurs the epidermis, which cools the body. That's why a person's skin becomes a flush, glowing and blushing, pink in color and feel hot to the touch when he or she is overheated. Here again in this figure, two processes, vasodilation and vasoconstriction. In the process of vasodilation, expansion of the blood vessels, this is an increase in their diameter so that more blood flows through them. In the process of vasodilation, heat loss by their connection and radiation. Relaxation of hair erector muscles. The hair erector muscles are attached with the hair. Whenever the heat is lost from the body, hair erector muscles relax and so the hair lies more or less flat against the skin. In this position, they offer the least possible obstruction to the heat lost by the radiation and convection. Two processes, overheating and overcooling. In the process of overheating, vasodilation. In the process of vasodilation, three steps, D, E or F. In the step D, hair muscles relax, hair lies flat, so heat can escape. In the step E, sweat secreted by the sweat gland, cool skin by evaporation. And last one is the F, blood flow in capillaries is increased. Compare with the too cold, vasoconstriction or overcooling. A, B, C are the steps. In the step A, hair muscles pull hair on end. B. Erect hair trapped air. C. Blood flow in capillaries is decreased. Two process, vasodilation, vasoconstriction. Number two is a sweating. Sweating is the production of water fluid containing dissolved salt from the sweat glands and the skin. As sweat evaporates from the skin, it has cooling effect because evaporating liquid carries away body heat. Any air movement over the body helps to speed up the evaporation of sweat, that is why fans, while not necessarily reducing the temperature of room, have a cooling effect on the body. This figure shows the sweating and the process of overheating and vasodilation. In this figure, overheating, vasodilation or sweating. Second is overcooling. If the body tends to lose more heat than it is generating, the following changes may take place. Number one is decrease in sweat production. In the process of decrease in sweat production, minimizes the heat loss by evaporation. Vasoconstriction. In vasoconstriction, constriction of arterioles which supply the surface makes smaller to heat loss. Vasoconstriction makes a person look pale or blue. In overcooling, vasoconstriction, constriction of arterioles. Next is increased metabolism. In increased metabolism, it releases more heat. Next is contraction of hair erector muscles. It raises the hair shell to an almost vertical position. It forms a film of air over the skin, forming an insulation. In this figure, it raises the hair shell to a vertical position. It forms a film of air over the skin, forming an insulation. In this figure, hair erector muscles will contract. Hair stand upright and vessels constrict. Next is shivering. The reflex action operates when the body temperature begins to drop. The spasmodic, irregular, spasming, violent, involuntary muscular contraction. The contraction of muscle is called shivering. This figure shows the overcooling, vasoconstriction or shivering. Shivering. It means rapid involuntary contraction or twitching of the muscles during exposure to the cold. It is the compensatory mechanism in the body during which enormous heat is produced. This contraction produces heat which helps to raise the body temperature. It is called shivering thermogenesis. Next is the brown fat, brown adipose tissue or brown fat is one of the two types of fats that human and other mammals have. Its main function is to turn food into body heat. It is sometimes called good fat. Human newborn and hibernating mammals have a high level of brown fat. Brown fat is also known as brown adipose tissue. It is one of the two types of fat in human and mammals. Brown fat's primary function is to generate body heat in newborn and animals, especially those that are hibernating. Mammals and humans with high level of brown fat take longer to start shivering. Newborns have a high level of brown fat while adults have a low level of brown fat. As humans get older, brown fat disappear and white fat increase. However, their function is similar. In this figure, white fat cell and brown fat cell. Brown fats, some mammals possess brown fats which is specialized for rapid heat production. Pyrexia. Fever, temperature in fever. Some disease producing an increase in temperature are known as fever. Definition of pyrexia. Fever is also known as pyrexia and febrile response as having a temperature and also causing body to overheat due to an increase in body temperature at a set point. There is not a single agreed upon upper limit for the normal temperature, with sources using the value between the 37.5 and 38.3 degrees centigrade, 99.5 and 100.9 Fahrenheit. Pyrogen. What is pyrogen? Certain chemicals are known as pyrogens. Pyrogens are toxins. These are produced by pathogenic organisms such as virus, bacteria or the substances released by the neutrophils. Neutrophils are WBC, white blood cells. Pyrogen directly affect the hypothalamus and increase the set point above 37 degrees centigrade. This raised body temperature stimulates the defense responses of body and helps the destruction of pathogens. Thanks for watching.